All right, regarding your homework assignment for this section, you're supposed to use a bunch of different JavaScript-enabled pages that interact with the database, and one of the first links you'll get is for test1simple.html. I'm not going to release this one. It's pretty close to the same thing, but if you want to come and review this video, you can and look at it. I have another page in which I just simply... this one's a little simpler, so I'll start off with this one, actually. You see that in this particular page, there's an HTML page, there's a script block in it that's in the body tag. It really doesn't matter whether it's in the head tag or the body tag. You can put the script in many places. And in this particular one, I set up the database information with four different parameters, open the database, and then this command creates a database, and it creates a database with that's called customer, that has an ID, a first name, last name, phone, address, city, state, zip, and age. So you can see examples in here of using integer data types and text data types. And the first one is actually a special one. So it's the primary key, and it's auto increment, which means that you don't, at least the auto increment part makes it so you don't ever have to enter in a number for that value. It'll just go from 1 to 2 to 3 automatically. So if I go over to this second one, I did the same thing, I just made it a little easier. I only made a couple field types or column types, first name and last name and ID for customer. I also added in this extra line right here, transaction .execute SQL, and it has a drop table. And then for the third and the fourth parameters that get passed in, I do a little function that can be used to just write to the console that a drop succeeded or that it failed. And so anyway, the last argument is that if it failed. Oops, having a hard time selecting that. One more time. All right, so there's the last argument after the last comma. Okay, now let's watch these things. Anyway, so we got two, which is inserting code, and three, which is selecting data, and four, which is deleting. So let's go ahead, and I want to show, so right here, here's a web browser where we can watch this. Now if I hit F12, it pops open something at the bottom. It's giving error messages about the Google page. But if I go over here under resources, it shows Web SQL right here. That means the database that's in your web browser automatically, but there's nothing there yet. If I hit return, suddenly it says I am the create table page. And now if there's a little arrow that's appeared there. If I open that, and if I click on that and then open that, there's now an empty customer database. So what happened was I ran this data and it created this database. So fantastic. All right, let's go on to the next one. Next tab, here's test 2. I'll go F12 and I will load this page and watch what happens. And I will open and open, and now there is the table and it has a row of data in it. And let's go over to console. Now there's some words there that say attempting to insert John and Doe. If I go back to my page for test 2, I have a little line in here that says console.log. You can use console.log to write to the console section in your browser so that you can see messages, or as you noticed earlier in your JavaScript lesson, you can also see errors that might occur there. But sometimes this is useful for development to see that there. All right, let's go on to the next one, F12. And then I will hit return to visit the page. And it showed me one thing that's in there. Actually, let me go back here and run this page again, the insert. Okay, I did an insert and I did an insert. Now there might be a, okay, so let's watch what happens. I hit return. Now there's three entries there. Let me go over to resources. Web SQL, mobile app, customer. All right. Let me reload this page one more time, because sometimes there's a little bug I've noticed that happens in Chrome where the database disappears. So I'll hit return, and look, the database is gone. OK, Okay, if I go over to console, it's still reading everything in there, but it somehow disappeared. If this happens to you, you can just grab that URL, open a tab, hit F12, and just type it in again somewhere else. And the database is back and it still has everything in there. So it's just a bug, the fact that it disappears. It's still there. And so I apologize for that. And then test 4, F12. Now, this is the page where I actually delete something. So I click that. And if I go over to console, looks like I didn't have anything, any debugging messages there. But if I go to Web SQL and customer, it deleted the first one. And that's actually the command that it's supposed to do. And if I were to go over to my select page, which was 3, and go to console, and then reload it, they're all sharing the exact same database. And it's only printing out these two now because there's a delete statement that deleted the first record. All right, so that should give you a good idea of what problem you might run into and also what these things do.